Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 8th of May. India begins mega repatriation operation to bring back stranded citizens. Pakistan to start easing lockdown from Saturday. And mosques reopen for prayers amid Bangladesh lockdown. And now for all the details. India has begun a mega repatriation operation to bring back thousands of its stranded nationals from abroad amid coronavirus pandemic. The mammoth exercise plans to evacuate nearly 15,000 Indian nationals from 12 countries in the first phase.
Air India's first flight that took off from Singapore carrying stranded Indian nationals on board landed at the Delhi airport on Friday afternoon. India on Thursday began a massive repatriation operation called Vande Bharat Mission to bring back thousands of Indian citizens stranded due to travel restrictions amid coronavirus pandemic. The 7-day long exercise aims to repatriate about 15,000 nationals from 12 countries on planes and naval ships. As part of the operation, two flights landed in India's southern Kerala province on Thursday night carrying 354 people from UAE. The passengers underwent thermal screening and those with mild symptoms were immediately sent to hospital for tests in ambulances. The Indian Navy has also joined the repatriation process and was scheduled to bring back around 200 citizens from Maldives on Friday. India's coronavirus cases tally reached 56,342 as of Friday, of whom 1,886 people have died, as the country has entered the third phase of lockdown until May 17 to contain the spread of the virus.
At least 16 migrant workers sleeping on railway tracks were crushed to death after a freight train ran over them in India's western Maharashtra province on Friday. Thousands of migrant workers have been walking home from India's big cities amid suspension of public transport because of coronavirus lockdown since late March.
A train ran over migrant workers sleeping on the track in Aurangabad in India's Maharashtra province on Friday, killing at least 16 of the group who were apparently on their way to their native villages, police said. Thousands of migrant workers have been walking home from India's big cities as most of the businesses remain closed and public transport remains suspended due to coronavirus lockdown since late March. The driver tried to stop the freight train when he saw the laborers on the tracks, but eventually hit them, the railway ministry said, adding it had ordered an inquiry.
पटरी पे सुबह 5:15 बजे बहुत ही अनफॉर्चुनेट तरीके से 16 मजदूरों की डेथ हो गई है 5:15 बजे यहाँ से जो कैरियर ट्रेन गुजर रही थी उसके नीचे वो लोग अनफॉर्चुनेटली आ गए हैं उनमें से एक इंजर्ड है वो हॉस्पिटल में है चार लोग जो थोड़ा दूर बैठे थे उनकी हम पूछताछ कर रहे हैं और वो थोड़ा सा सदमे में है
Prime Minister Narendra Modi said in a tweet that he is extremely anguished by the loss of lives and that he has spoken to Railway Minister Piyush Goyal about the incident. This comes as the Indian government had issued an order last week to provide special trains for stranded migrant workers, pilgrims, tourists and students to return home as lockdown was extended until May 17th with some relaxations.
hours after Pakistan announced its highest daily increase in new coronavirus cases on Thursday. Prime Minister Imran Khan said that the country will begin lifting its lockdown on Saturday. The decision has raised fears the outbreak will worsen.
Pakistan will begin lifting its coronavirus lockdown on Saturday. Prime Minister Imran Khan said on Thursday, hours after the country announced its highest daily increase in new cases. Pakistan, where a poorly enforced shutdown has been in place since late March, has recorded over 24,950 cases of COVID-19, with more than 590 deaths. Khan said the shutdown would be lifted in phases and warned people that the disease could get out of control if they didn't take precautions. The government said that initially small markets and shops would be allowed to open until 5 p.m., although big malls and other spaces would remain closed. Schools will also stay closed until July 15, while communal prayers have been allowed for the holy month of Ramadan.
We have decided to open the lockdown, and I will tell you, lockdown will open Saturday. It will not open tomorrow, Saturday, inshallah.
The government's handling of the virus has been strongly criticized by scientists and doctors who fear the outbreak will gather pace among a population of more than 200 million and overwhelm the country's struggling health system.
लेकिन कि हम खुद चाह रहे हैं कि ये बीमारी किसी से कंट्रोल हो कि हम आजादी से घूम सके फिर सके कोई घर के लिए कोई रोटी पानी तो कर सके
Fears for the economy are said to be the main reason for relaxing the lockdown. The IMF and the World Bank have forecast a bleak economic outlook for Pakistan as it heads towards a major recession.
U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has said he was appalled to see reports last week that Iranian border guards abused, tortured and drowned Afghan migrants. Pompeo called on Afghan government to open a full investigation and hold perpetrators accountable.
U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo has said he is appalled by the reports that say Afghan migrants were abused, tortured and drowned by Iranian border guards. Pompeo in a press conference said this happened when Afghans dared to cross the border simply in search of food and work. He called on the Afghan government to open a full investigation and hold perpetrators accountable. Over 50 Afghan migrants were trying to cross the border when they were tortured and drowned by Iranian guards, according to eyewitnesses. Afghan officials and survivors say the incident took place on May 1.
I was appalled to see reports last week of Iranian guards on the border of Afghanistan's Herat province abused, tortured, drowned Afghan migrants who dared to cross the border simply in search of food and work. We encourage the Afghan authorities to undertake a full investigation and to seek to hold those perpetrators accountable.
The United States has condemned the incident and encouraged the Afghan authorities to undertake a full investigation. The matter has now triggered a diplomatic crisis between the Iran and Afghanistan, which share trade, economic and cultural ties. Iran has denied that such an incident took place on its soil. Iran says about 2.5 million Afghan migrants, both legal and undocumented, mostly from Herat province, are in Iran after failing to find work in war-ravaged Afghanistan.
In news from Bangladesh, mosques reopened for congregational prayers across Bangladesh on Thursday as the holy month of Ramadan is underway. However, the government has issued strict guidelines for worshippers and mosque authorities as it eased lockdown restrictions.
Mosques reopened on Thursday across Bangladesh for prayers during holy month of Ramadan after being closed for nearly a month and a half due to a nationwide lockdown to stem the spread of coronavirus. Dozens of worshippers who entered Dhaka's Baitul Mukarram National Mosque were required to wash hands and maintain social distancing during noon prayers. Bangladesh enforced a nationwide lockdown on March 26th amid a surge in coronavirus cases but is now gradually easing restrictions.
Dirgho dermash coronai bonder karone ajke prothom masjid kholar আমরা প্রথম এখানে নামাজে জামাতে নামাজ পড়া আদায় করার জন্য এখানে আসছি। আজান হওয়ার পর গেট খুললে আমরা সবাই মসজিদে ঢুকবো এবং একসাথে জামাতে ডিস্টেন্স মেনটেন করে নিয়ম শৃঙ্খলা পালন করে তারপর মসজিদে আমরা নামাজ আদায় করতে চাই।
Bangladesh Religious Affairs Ministry has issued guidelines for worshippers which make wearing face mask and maintaining at least 1 meter distance from each other mandatory while offering prayers. Mosque authorities have been told to regularly disinfect floors, remove carpets and provide hand washing or sanitizing facilities. However, public health experts have voiced concern over the decision as coronavirus cases continue to spike in Bangladesh. As of Friday, the country reported 199 deaths and 12,425 cases of the virus.
Buddhists in Sri Lanka and Nepal marked Buddha Day with most people celebrating the occasion at homes amid coronavirus lockdown. The occasion is celebrated every year in May with great pomp and fervor, but this year the festivities were affected by the coronavirus outbreak worldwide.
Celebrations to commemorate the birth, enlightenment and death of Lord Buddha were low-key in Sri Lankan capital Colombo on Thursday, with most people homebound due to a lockdown to prevent the spread of novel coronavirus. The Buddha Day or the Bisak Day is celebrated on the full moon day in May every year and is the most important religious festival for the Buddhists, who are majority in Sri Lanka. The festivities usually go on for at least a week. But this year, decorations were few in general and most of the people celebrated the day at home with homemade lanterns amid the coronavirus outbreak in the country.
තංග අපි එළියට ගිහිලා තොරම් බලලා කූඩු බලලා විතර විනෝද වෙනවා නමුත් මේ සරේව කරන්න බෑ අපි ගෙවල් වලම මේ උත්සවය සමරන්න තමයි මේ පාර කටයුතු කරේ.
Meanwhile, similar nationwide coronavirus lockdown resulted in no buzz at a Buddha shrine in Nepal on the occasion. Every year, long queues of worshippers are seen outside Swambhunath temple on Buddha Day, also called Buddha Jayanti. But this year, government's strict directive to stay away from places hosting mass gatherings caused less footfall at the World Heritage Site in capital Kathmandu.
As Indian capital New Delhi continues to report new coronavirus cases and deaths due to it, a gravedigger expressed loyalty towards his work, saying someone has to help bury the victims as humanity comes first.
Belonging to the third generation in a family of Indian cemetery workers, Mohammad Shamim had little choice in life than to dig graves. A pandemic like coronavirus has made his work dangerous. Shamim now witnesses families in Indian capital New Delhi while they bury their loved ones, the victims of coronavirus. There are times when there aren't enough mortuary workers and men to lift the dead bodies. Then Shamim has to help.
अब सर सभी मना कर देंगे तो कोई तो करेगा, फेंका तो जा नहीं सकता, इंसान ही है वो भी, थोड़ा सा कमेटी ने भी कहा और फिर लोगों ने कहा, फिर सबसे बड़ी बात है इंसानियत खुद के अंदर भी होनी चाहिए, अगर हम भी पीछे हट जाएंगे तो कौन करेगा सर।
At the time when hundreds of people are dying due to the novel coronavirus in India, fears over the spread from the bodies of the victims have made the situation even worse. Some families in India cannot even bid final goodbye to the family members, as many are being kept under quarantine. Infections have crossed 56,000 mark with over 1,800 deaths in India, despite a nationwide lockdown imposed since March 24th.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter at sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.